When I was younger, I was so naive to believe that freedom is an acquired good that no one could take away from us. Freedom is difficult to be acquired and maintained. And young people need to understand this very well, before it's too late. Also, war can take place at any time. History teaches us. How much your freedom is worth to you? Would you give your life for it? Would you be sacrificed so next generations could live freely? I'll try to answer these questions through the historical Greek paradigm of November 17th of 1973. I'm the professor with a bow tie. Watch this video till the end, and if you like the content of it, hit the subscribe button and also the like button. Thank you very much. Enjoy.
Ένα το χέλι πόνι κι η άνοιξη ακριβή για να γυρίσει ο ήλιος.
On July 15, in 1965, George Papandreou lost his power to the conservatives. George Papandreou was the leader of the center-left party who supported the popular strata. On the other hand, the conservative forces consisted of the King Konstantinos and the party of Konstantinos Karamanlis, called ERE, the initials of which mean National Radical Union. The ERE party and the King allied to disband the party of Papandreou. They created a party that served their interests, but on the surface would have a popular face to be widely accepted. This is how the government was sworn in on September 17 in 1965, without an electoral process, but with a vote of confidence from the parliament. But this government did not have social support and provoked reactions. Thus, a temporary caretaker government was created to defuse the situation. However, despite the efforts of conservatives to weaken the left with conspiracies and unsubstantiated accusations, the power of George Papandreou did not diminish, and if elections were held, he would surely have won. A typical example of conspiracy was the case of Aspida, it means shield, where he was accused of alleged conspiracy against the state. The only solution for the king and the conservatives was the constitutional deviation. The coup was based on the fear spread by the conservatives that a popular front would be created and the traditional order of things that conservatives wanted to control would be overthrown. In 1967, the colonels Papadopoulos, Patakos, Ioannidis, Ladas, Lekas, Roufogalis decided to proceed with the coup, which took place on April 21st after a series of dark actions by the aforementioned colonels headed by Papadopoulos. The first actions of Papadopoulos were to arrest the political leaders of the parties and the dissidents in general, and to abolish the parties. The newspapers were censored. He imposed the law on the state of siege, according to which some articles of the constitution ceased to apply. For example, citizens could be arrested without a warrant. Searches of homes were conducted without a warrant. All rallies, strikes, trade unions were banned, and all crimes were under the jurisdiction of the emergency military tribunals. The reaction to this new regime did not take long to come. During the seven-year dictatorship, many resistance movements and groups emerged. On the other hand, the dictatorial regime tried to eliminate the creation of these groups by setting up trials, imprisonments, tortures, and exile. The students played a key role in the fall of the regime. The National Technical University of Athens participated in the past in struggles against the fascism in 1940. So the students of this institution took the lead by complaining of fraud in student elections of 1972. The first reactions of the students started in 1973. They decided to occupy the law school after a series of restrictions imposed by the dictatorial regime. In the same year, the funeral of Papandreou strengthens the popular mobilization. On November 14, in 1973, the Polytechnic School was occupied by the students. The Squatting Coordinating Committee ensures that the entrances are guarded and that slogans are broadcast on the radio of the Polytechnic School to strengthen the popular mind. Hundreds of citizens flock outside the university to express their support for the students. The main demand of the resistance was the immediate overthrow of the tyrannical regime and the restoration of popular sovereignty. When the government of Papadopoulos realizes the widespread movement of people, on Friday, November 16, sends police forces to clash with the protesters outside the Polytechnic School. At midnight on Friday, armed units and tanks arrive and turn their fire on the Polytechnic School. Students from loudspeakers call on the armed forces not to shed Greek blood, but in vain. On November 17 of 1973, a tank knocks down the main gate of the Polytechnic School. Hundreds of students are arrested, 18 dead and more than 1,000 injured is the sad record of the regime's violence. These events led the government to take even more authoritarian measures. Martial law is declared and a curfew is imposed after 4 p.m. Under the internal and external pressures and mostly in front of the danger of military engagement with Turkey in summer of 1974, following the July 20 invasion of Cyprus, the colonels will be forced to hand over power to politicians. So the authoritarian regime was led to its downfall and the student movement of that time was crowned with the laurels of immortality. Today, on November 17 of every year, the revolutionary and non-aligned thinking of youth, the ideals of freedom and justice, and the final victory of democracy are celebrated. Events are organized throughout the country, with marches of workers, of students, and of the whole people, to glorify the healthy disobedience to any attempt to restrict freedom.
Της δικαιοσύνης ηγενόητε και μυρσύνη εσύ δοξάστηκε.